Today we have to discuss the most important topic, the cell unit of life. As we know, cell is structural and functional unit of life. That means cell itself form all the structural organization in case of organisms. Then whatever the function which is take place in case of living beings is only with the help of what? Cell. Therefore, when you consider the living beings and non-living things, the basic difference is that the cell having a specially body, we call the name living being or organisms or life forms we called. If there is no cell, at that time there is no life at all. Without cell having entities, we called non-living things. Don't call it as a dead, non-living things. They are the matter which may not having cell, they may not having life at all. But living beings are characterized by presence of basic unit, that is called the name cell. Then the organism may form by single cell also. That single cell organisms we mainly called unicellular organism. It is very wonderful that unicellular organisms, the single cell itself perform all the function. For example, digestion, respiration, excretion, circulation, movement, reproduction, genetic continuity. All the living being characters can exist in unicellular organisms. Or there may be the organism body may be composed of many cells. Such organisms generally be called multicellular organism. In multicellular organism, once again basically cell itself is a functional unit where there may be little bit modification. Group of similar cells may form tissues, or different tissues may together form organ, or different organs together form a organ system. In such a way, in a different way, living beings' body is organized. But once again, basic unit, structural and functional unit of organism is cell itself. There is a wonderful history with the cell life. The Antoni van Leeuwenhoek first time saw the living cell. Then the Robert Brown, eminent cytologist, identified the center of all living being cells, was a specialized master cell organelle. Its name is nucleus. Later, two eminent scientists, one Skeldon and another one Scavan, proposed a cell theory. The Skeldon was a German botanist. He explained that all the plants having a special, what you say, unit, plant cells. Therefore, all plant cells are generally together form plant body. Hence, plant body is structurally and functionally organized with a basic unit cell. At the same time, a British zoologist, Scavan, explained that in case of animals, there is a specialized basic microscopic unit is there. That unit is called cell, and that cell having a simple membrane. That membrane now we called as a plasma membrane. Hence, today we know that in case of animal cell, there is only one boundary is there, cell membrane or plasma membrane. There is no cell wall. Whereas in plant cell, the double covering is there, cell wall along with that one more semipermeable membrane, plasma membrane is there. And he also proposed that the animal body is organized with microscope unit, that are cells. By this, what indicates the cell theory proposed, all organisms body is composed of basic unit. That unit is called the name cell. Therefore, cell is structural and functional unit of a life, we say. Then one of eminent cytologist Rudolf Virchow explained that cell arise from pre-existing cell. That in Greek itself he named as cellula e hominis cellula. That means cell originated from already existing cell. That itself indicates cell have capacity of self-duplication, cell have ability of replication. That itself what we call the name cell division. That cell division concept was clearly explained by Rudolf Virchow. Finally, the cell theory, we can conclude that the organism's body is composed of a single cell or group of cell. That is the idea. And second concept is cell is a structural and functional unit of life. The two important concepts are explained by cell theory. If we take a typical cell, generally the cell is protected by outer covering. That is, we call cell wall. Basically, cell wall only found in case of plant cell, as well as in case of prokaryotes, there may be presence of cell wall. But in case of animals, cell wall is absent. Hence, in case of animal cell, only one covering is there. Its name is cell membrane or plasma membrane. Whereas in case of plant cell, there is a presence of cell wall as well as cell membrane or double membrane. There are exceptional unicellular organisms are there, especially in case of prokaryotes. If you take bacteria, where we have a capsule, then after that cell wall, cell membrane, as a three coatings we have. Therefore, most of organisms cell is protected by a protective coverings. They mainly includes cell wall and cell membrane. Then remaining a whatever the living content present within that covering, that we called protoplasm. That protoplasm includes two components. One is nucleus, another one cytoplasm. Therefore, protoplasm commonly we called living content of cell. That means life exists in a cell due to presence of this specialized component, protoplasm. That protoplasm basically a living content of organism. It's a physical basis of life. That means physical appearance to the cell, to the organism, given by protoplasm. That physical appearance means either it means you take shape, size, color, height, position, all these are physical appearance. That physical appearance for organism is due to presence of protoplasm. Suppose my body color is a black, that means my protoplasmic content mainly contain more melanin, we say. like that if my body color is white, in the my protoplasm the specially melanin content is less. Like that if my body color is red, specially the melanin content is in the protoplasm medium quantity. Therefore the specially what we can say, protoplasm gives vesical appearance. Suppose I am tall, protoplasm is rich. If I am dark, protoplasm is less. If I am having a medium height, at that time protoplasm is medium quantity. Like that, protoplasm gives us as well as all organism vesical appearance. In that we have two component, one is nucleus, another one cytoplasm. Already as I mentioned, first time the eminent cytologist Robert Brown identified one of the important cell organ, that's what we call the name, a master cell organ, nucleus. That nucleus having a boundary called nuclear membrane. That means cell having its own membrane, that is cell wall and cell membrane. Like that, nucleus has its own compound, its own protective covering, that called nuclear membrane. In that, to nourish the nucleus, there is a liquid called nucleoplasm. The most important component, the whole function of what we called a nucleus is generally based on that chromatin material, where the basic genetic material, what we called DNA, is packed properly. And to organize the function of nucleus, one more small part is there, what we called nucleolus. Then if you consider another major component, from nucleus to cell membrane, whatever the component is there, that what we call cytoplasm. Simply cytoplasm is not that dotted structure. All the living parts along with that ergastic substance we call cytoplasm. But in cytoplasm we have very important basic unit, that's what we call a living component, that we call cell organelles. That means parts of cell. They are the specially a life having component. But please you remember, the single mitochondria may not shows the a living character, or Golgi complex may not shows the singly living character. Altogether, if they are present in a cell, that cell acts as a basic unit of life. Therefore, here you take mitochondria, it's a powerhouse of cell, produce energy. Golgi complex is a best packing center, it pack all material. Plastids, mainly the chloroplast, it prepare food by a phenomenon called photosynthesis. Ribosomes, we call protein factories of the cell. Whatever the specially protein required for the cell is synthesized by rhizosomes. Lysosomes removes the unwanted material from the body, and they will also call suicide bags of the cell. Centrosomes play a very important role to form a spindle and also flagella and cilia. Microbodies responsible for storage. Like that, different cell organelles present in a specially cytoplasm. Along with that, there is a plenty of non-living material is there, that we call non-living inclusion or non-living material, that includes mainly we called as a ergastic substance. It may be waste, that is excretory product. Some of them stored food material, either it may be protein, even what we called the carbohydrate, lipids, minerals, or sometimes even vitamins also. And there are plenty of secreted metals are also there, like latex. Then we may say different types of saints, fragrance, nectar, like that. The different secreted metal, including plenty of hormones and enzymes, especially in case of both animals and plants. This is the specially overall view of a typical cell, either it may be plant cell, animal cell, or prokaryotic cell. If you take cell size, although most of the cells are microscopic, the size is highly variable. Smallest cell in the nature, that is especially a prokaryotic cell, mycoplasma, having just 0.3 micron in diameter. At the same time, most of the bacterial cell measures about 3 to 5 micron only. Then if you take red blood corpuscles in our body, having a diameter the 7 to 8 micron. Then the algae by the name Astrobilaria, where the cell size may be 10 centimeter. As we know, in case of higher plants, the sclerenchyma is a dead mechanical tissue. It includes two types. One is sclerites, another one sclerenchyma fiber. These sclerenchyma fibers, especially in case of some fiber yielding plants like agave, hemp, jute, in all these cases, the size may be 2 to 3 feet long. Then human neuron, if you consider, it start from human brain and innervate up to the end of toe. That means the length of single neuron may be 5 to 6 feet, although the person having medium height like 5.5, like that. Then like that, even if you consider cell shape also, it is highly variable. Why the cell shape is variable? Although we are saying that simply, if you take animal cell spherical in nature, plant cell elongated cylindrical, like that, generally, in general speaking we say, because most of the animal cell, when you consider, they are spherical in nature, therefore in general speaking spherical shape. Whereas if you take plant cell, the plant cells are elongated and cylindrical. It's a general view. That means most of the animal cells are spherical in nature, most of the plant cells are elongated and cylindrical. But still there are plenty of cells in both the animals as well as plants body showing lot of variation. For example, if you take the RBC in side view, it is dumbbell shape. Whereas in case of the surface view, it is circular and biconcave. It is dumbbell shape, we say. At the same time, if you take white blood corpuscles, either you take monocyte or in other words the eosinophils, or the specially heterophils or neutrophils, or in other words the basophils, they are all irregular in shape, or in other words amoeboid in shape. At the same time, if you take a neuron, they are elongated, a thread-like structure with what you say, the specially a star-like cell body. It's what we called neuron, we say. At the same time, if you take mesophyll tissues found in the leaves of the plant, they are elongated, pillar-like, with rich chloroplast-containing specialized cells are there. Almost all, they look like a pillar. If you consider the tracheids of the specially a xylem elements, they are once again spindle shape with smaller what you called the conducting vesicles are there. Then at the same time, if you consider dicot stomatal guard cells, they become a bean shape or kidney shape for their function. By this, what it indicates, they have different what you say the functional specialization. For example, if you take RBC, to increase the surface area for oxygen carrying, they become circular dumbbell shape. Whereas WBC, they have to attack the foreign invaders. They have their own shell movement, amoeboid movement. Therefore, they become irregular shape. Suppose you take neuron, they have to conduct what impulses or message. Hence, they become elongated wire-like structure and convey the message to the various parts of the body. If you consider mesophyll tissue, they are tall pillar-like, compactly arranged with rich chloroplast content is there, and they are modified for photosynthesis process. If you take tracheids of xylem, they are just a tubular structure, vessel-like structure, pipe-like structure, helps for conduction of what? Water. If you consider stomatal guard cells here, they become beam-shaped. As a result, stomata can open and close and conduct both transpiration and respiration. Like that, both the plant as well as the animal shell or most of the organism cells having different shapes based on their functional modification or functional requirement. Yeah.